Welcome back, friends. So now we are in the last part of the video for transformation of graphs. In this video, we will recap all the 10 transformations which we covered in the previous parts of the video along with their applications. So I have taken this graph, some random graph, just to explain how 10 transformations work. Okay. So in the same axis, I will draw the graphs after transformation one by one. Okay. So this graph is suppose fx. Suppose you want to draw f of x plus 2. For f of x plus 2, the whole graph will be shifted 2 units upward. Okay. So graph will be something like this. Okay, so this will be f of x plus 2. You can see that each and every point of the graph is shifted 2 units upward. Okay, suppose you could draw graph of f of x minus 1. Then the whole graph will be shifted 1 unit towards right. So it will become like this. Like this. Okay. The whole graph is shifted 1 unit towards right. Okay. You can see that each and every point is shifted 1 unit towards right. That is graph of f of x minus 1. Suppose we could draw graph of minus fx. So minus fx will be obtained by taking the mirror image with respect to x-axis. It will look like this. So this will be minus fx. This was f of x minus 1. Suppose we could draw f of minus x. F of minus x can be obtained by taking the mirror image with respect to y-axis. Okay? So that will be like this. Okay? So this will be the graph of f of minus x. Okay? Suppose we have to draw the graph of mod fx. For mod fx, whatever portion is below x-axis, you have to bring it up. So this will be the graph of mod fx. Fine. So this is my graph of mod fx. Suppose I have to draw graph of f of mod x. So f of mod x will be obtained by ignoring the graph which is on the left hand side and copying the graph which is on the right hand side to the left. So f of mod x will be like this. I can't label it because this graph is already having some parts common with other graphs. But whenever you try to understand how the graph was drawn, you can go back to the video and then see the movement of my pen and you understand how the graph has been drawn. Okay? Now suppose you have to draw the graph of 2fx. So graph of 2fx will be obtained by stretching the graph along y-axis. That will be something like this. Okay, how to draw graph of f of 2x. Okay, so f of 2x we obtained by compressing the graph along x-axis. Compressing the graph along x-axis. So that will be something like this. Okay, now suppose you have to draw graph of f inverse x. Okay, that's very crowded graph, but I can just tell you that you draw y equal to x line and then take the mirror image with respect to this line. So the mirror image will look like this. Okay, I know it's very crowded, but if you see the movement of my pen and you remember the original graph, you can understand, okay? So that is the graph of f inverse x. Now it's very crowded, so I won't cover the last part because anyway, 1 by fx I have just covered in the previous part, so you can see from there again. So this is how the different transformations work. Okay, overall, it's very easy to understand, to figure out how a transformation will be drawn, okay, but you are supposed to learn them by heart. So you should not take time in thinking how you have to do it. You should remember them all the time. It should be on the tip of your tongue, okay? So this is the end of our video, transformation of graphs. I request you to like the video, share the video, and subscribe our channel. Thank you so much.